picking up shots. Picking up shots while I'm waiting to render. Well, the render's happening.
Referring to notes I'm rendering in the background. Upcoming on my playlists here on YouTube, I've got two different playlists which I'm maintaining at the moment, adding new content as we go. First one's called Revised Iridium Air. It's got the most videos on it. That's mostly all point of view stuff from me. I also have another one called Indie Sidelines. That's almost a documentary style channel where it's longer events, sometimes rallies, sometimes protests, sometimes town hall meetings, things of that nature. Sometimes demonstrations. I've got three upcoming projects that I'd like to talk about here while I've got a little bit of time to do so. I'm going to need volunteers, number one, to shoot something called The Letter. It's a document which was prepared by another group, and somebody who I've been involved with in the recent past, but I was curiously drawn to an idea which I followed through with. The letter has been cut up with a metaphorical razor into strips, specifically separating each line of the letter. So I need volunteers to match the number of lines in the letter. That number is less than 33. So if you'd like to do that with me, I've got the lines on my person. Most of the time I'm in public. You can come up and talk to me about doing that if I'm not already talking to somebody else about doing it. And if I am, please wait patiently. I will get to you very soon. Two, bring a book. If you're going out in public somewhere around where you know I might be filming, bring a book and approach me and let me know that you're interested in reading one line for the camera, one line of the book. I'll be compiling every little clip. I guess I'll need, you can identify yourself if you wish to or not. If you want to wear a mask, I will not be reporting it to the cops. The compilation video will come out at some later point in time, but I'll probably only be taking shots for the book, the lines from the book, until the letter project, which I immediately talked before. Number one, number two. Number one, when that's done, the book compilation video will also be coming out, I think. Number three, I have planned to do a Vox Populi type segment, probably for Indie Sidelines. And that means that I'll be acting as a, not so much an open microphone, but an open mic plus camera. So you can ask a question directly to my camera, and then I will directly put it onto the channel with a minimum of editing. Now, obviously some questions and some statements are considered libelous and slanderous, so I would prefer to not get caught holding the libelous and slanderous bag. I have to do some investigation into some things which I might or might not know when I've been presented with them. So if you have any kind of supporting documentation or ability to show me where I might want to start looking to verify what it is you're saying or to disprove it, then please be prepared. But for the Vox Populi, most of the time, say your piece and I haven't got a problem with you. For the first one, I think I'm going to be looking for questions for the Premier Ball and Minister Bennett. The Premier Ball.
Cameras are turning.
I like that. The Premier Ball. Well, we all wore dresses and danced all night. Speaking of questions for the Premier Ball.
Oh! united, will never be defeated. The people, 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 united.
Guys with the union, one guy comes out with a flag and you're done. It doesn't work. You need the union, the whole network.
Up with us, and you want to get your heart pumping and you want to do some yelling in the streets, meet up with us at the clock tower over here at MUN at 11:30 or 11:45. Okay, otherwise, if you want to stand up on the hill, it's going to be a family-friendly event. There's going to be some music. It's going to be cotton candy, I'm told. That's why I'm going.
Yeah, cotton candy!
What's a revolution without cotton candy, eh? I just wanted to let everybody
Red
know.
Red circuses and cotton candy.
Saturday is going to be a big day, so make sure that you're out again, okay? Solidarity, people, solidarity.
Yeah!
So.
A tax increase for higher income earners. They want to raise the HST. That's something they campaigned against. Raising the cost of insurance registration and increasing the price of gasoline by 16.5 cents. A new tax on books. Shutting down 54 libraries provincially. No! What message does that send? Because it's not people matter. And to eliminate a provincial job search engine. Not that there'd be any jobs left to look for. I'm new to this. The best part is, there's more to come in the fall. Is this some sort of joke? Because forgive my ignorance, I don't get it. How are we as a society supposed to have confidence in a government which ran in an election on campaigns of lies and false promises? We cannot tax ourselves into prosperity. And what can we do to stop this? We are doing it. Right here, right now. We must stand together. We must continue to rally and demonstrate. We must fight this budget until we are heard.
Mike Hogan. Speaking of questions for the premier ball, seeing as I wasn't exactly nice about the asked me many questions earlier. I mean, earlier yesterday when I was filming, maybe filming today, other than this. Number one question for Premier Ball. Would you care to explain the Premier Ball, why you are willing to play to the tunes of the previous governments, the immediately previous governments, and why Credit Rating is the name of one of those tunes? Yeah, I'm not laughing. Number two, given the concerns of untold numbers of constituents, of the members of your own caucus, are you concerned that your period as leader will be short and necessarily brutal, the better to sell the next big swindle? I mean puppet. Yeah, libelous and slanderous, right? I mean, questions for Minister Bennett. Number one, what do you think your chances are for the party leadership now, given the previous month of protests?
I'm going to change batteries while I get a chance.
I would like to hear an answer to that one. I really would. And number two, some people, myself included, would be willing to concede that books are sometimes a luxury item, I mean, which accounts for a fairly substantial amount of book sales per year in this province. This is no reason to ignore other luxury items, which are not taxed. So have you considered at least taxing junk food and fast food, Minister Bennett? As an aside to that question, I'm going to be a little more blunt. I haven't looked up to see what the tax regime is yet on junk food or on fast food, although I have looked up the Consumer Price Index and noted that it's a 40% increase in the last 10 or 15 years for something that I could say a McDonald's or a Tim Hortons. And the best figure or estimate I could see for sales in Newfoundland and Labrador for fast food items, or for fast food as like a sector, apparently only $750,000 annually. And that's figures from between 2013 and now. This seems awful low, actually, come to think of it. Junk food and fast food is not taxed enough would be a contention I would be willing to make, I think. And it doesn't really care what tax bracket the consumer is in, either. We don't obviously have to tax fast food items at the consumer level, like as a sales tax. We don't necessarily have to use a sales tax. We could tax the profits of the business itself rather than increasing any given unit on the line, or charging the consumer directly a sales tax, which is then remitted to government as sales tax. No, I don't think we need to do that, do we, Minister Bennett? Because we could just tax the profits of the business itself, the same as the payrolls are going to be, you know, taking the brunt of where the levy comes from. Isn't that right, Minister Bennett? Isn't that right? We could tax the profits of the business, not the consumer, with a sales tax. Wow.
I'm going to have to break it. sleep or wait for a minute or two. Let's hope. They could try to sneak out of here, yeah.
Yeah,
we're
off roads
today.
Don't worry, Paul showed up the sky. That's the only ball I likes to see.
Just
to make it like this, and I don't see people like. Sorry.
Show your face!
Did you wear a red just to get in? What? Did you wear a red just to get in?
Did you behave?
Behave or behaved out, is it?
Did you put it up in your what?
And I still think I should just air out all the dirty laundry so we don't have to deal with this again. How powerful is this? Yep. Yep.
Sun to our back is not a bad thing all the time. They don't get too easy pictures. Here we go.
We will pay.
won't pay. Just the we won't pay. We won't pay.
Just the truth. We just won't the pay.
Praise we the corporate pay. Income tax.
Just the truth. Just the facts.
Raise the corporate income tax.
Just the truth. Just the facts.
Raise the corporate income tax.
Just the truth.
Hello, Pinocchio. Hello, Pinocchio. Yes, sir. How are you doing, Pinocchio? Is your nose going to get any bigger, Pinocchio? Hey, Kathy, would you like fries with that? Hey, Kathy, when was the last time you took a 15-cent pay raise? 15 cents an hour sound good to you, Kathy? Got no strings to hold them down, to make them laugh or make them frown. See you later, Pinocchio. Lie to us and you're next. My God, how big a fucking truck does that asshole need? Lord Jesus, what kind of gas does that thing burn? Fucking jeez. I'm walking home. I don't know about you bastards.